This video will give you an introduction to client scripts and some pointers to help you get started in the right direction. You can incorporate scripts into the ServiceNow system to extend and customize its features. These scripts are coded in JavaScript. Scripts can run on the server and on client browsers. Since the server has direct access to the database, server scripts are typically used to modify records in the database and generate events. Since the client has access to forms, client scripts are typically used to tailor forms to the current user and conditions. This video looks at these client scripts. Client scripts are useful for configuring forms, form fields, and field values in real time while the user is using the form. For example, a script can make fields hidden or visible, read-only or writable, or optional or mandatory based on the user's role. A script can also set the value in one field based on the values in other fields, modify the options in a choice list based on the user's role, or display messages based on the value in a field. They're a powerful way to tailor a form in real time. You can see a list of all the client scripts in the instance at System Definition, Client Scripts. To see the client scripts for a particular form, go to the form, open the context menu, and choose Configure Client Scripts. There are a few different types of script. An onLoad script runs when the form loads, before the user ever sees it. The values in the form are straight from the database. This type of script lets you control how the form first appears to the user. An onChange script runs when the user changes the value in any field. This type of script is handy for setting the value of a field or displaying a message based on the values the user enters in other fields. An onSubmit script runs when the user submits the form. This type of script is useful for validating the values that the user entered. And finally, onCellEdit scripts are similar to onChange, except that they run whenever the user changes the value of a field in a list rather than on a form. Client scripts interact with the system through a small set of APIs. Let's go back to our list of scripts for the incident form and take a look. Client scripts control forms and their fields and values through an API called GlideForm. The script calls the GlideForm API through the GForm object. GForm methods let you do lots of things with forms and fields, like highlight areas on the form, get information or set the value for a field, and change the choices in a list. The GlideUser API provides information about the current user through the GUser object. GUser methods and properties provide the user's names, user ID, roles, and other information. The GlideRecord API makes calls to the database on the server without having to use MySQL. This API uses the GR object. And finally, the Glide Ajax API passes work to the server in a script include. This API uses the Ajax object. Now let's look at a few best practices for client scripts. The base system comes with hundreds of scripts. If you want to change one of these scripts, make a copy and change the copy rather than changing the base version. That way you can go back to the base version if you need to. Here's another tip. Some form fields don't contain the actual data. Instead, they contain a reference to the data on the server. These fields have a button with an information icon. Client scripts need to make a call to the server to get the data for these fields. This takes extra time. To improve client performance, try to make as few references to these fields as possible. Another way to improve client performance is to run longer scripts on the server instead of the client. you can use Glide Ajax to pass a script to the server in a script include. And finally, be sure to put comments in your code. It'll be a big help to the next person who sees it, and that just might be you a few months down the road. For more information, please consult our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.